attorneys, but only if the homeowner is willing to pay.
The city had planned to cut down about 1,300 trees, but once the removal started, residents objected. So the city halted the plan and reconsidered. Kristen Barbarisi has recovered on tonight's decision. Kristen.
Greg and Amber, it was a compromise here at City Hall tonight with the council and residents in agreement. Anyone with a healthy ash tree outside their home will be able to pay $75 a year to have it treated. The council voted unanimously to allow people to save their trees, but only using a treatment called Triazid. It's more expensive, costing between $100 and $300, but council members voiced concerns that a less expensive chemical posed a public health risk. That means the city will pay some of the cost, with residents, again, only paying $75. Council members against the city paying the entire cost to treat all the ash trees say it's not fair to taxpayers. One resident whose street is lined with ash trees says she's pleased with this outcome.
I'm happy that they made a compromise. You know, the city's going to pay for part of the treatment. So is it everything I wanted? No, but I think it's a good compromise and it's able to save a lot of the trees in Sun Prairie.
The cost of trying to keep trees alive for 20 or 30 years means we don't put in the traffic light someplace at some intersection. Maybe we don't get to pay for the $1 million fire truck. It's not just the trees, it's what we don't get to do that's also important.
At a meeting last week, the city was concerned about a $175,000 contract they signed to have all the trees removed, but that company agreed to only charge for the trees that they do cut down. Now, any tree that is not paid for by a resident will be cut down. The council also voted tonight to use that more expensive treatment on the 150 trees that they already planned to treat. Originally, some of those trees were scheduled to get that less expensive chemical. Live in Sun Prairie, Kristen Barbarisi, 27 News.
All right, good update tonight, Kristen. Thank you.